Sure.
Okay. Take a look at this. Here, this is eastern Oklahoma. We're flooding. A big problem there because of all the heavy rain they've seen over the last several days. There's a stretch of highway in a really small town of Wister that's in LaFleur County. Yeah, they're making the best of it.
Yeah.
The town's underwater, a lot of the areas there, but, you know, they're fishing.
Yeah.
They're trying to make the best of the situation
right
there.
You can do that there. Wow.
Yeah. You know, we got some rain here, but you talk about southeast Oklahoma.
Yeah, just last week they were in a drought. Just like us.
Right.
And now they're officially out of the drought and they're dealing with those flooding rains.
Right.
Look at the rainfall totals here on this graphic. Southeast portions of the state, Idabel, nearly 17 inches of rain just in the last 2 weeks. And really, it's only the last 11 days.
And western Oklahoma, they need some of that.
Right. You could add every month from now all the way through August here in Oklahoma City, and we still do not see that much rain as they've seen in just 11 days there in Idabel. So feast or famine, we love crazy weather here in Oklahoma. And boy, if we had it here recently with those heavy rains, drought conditions northwest, we've seen sleet, even some severe weather in the form of wind and hail as, we're heading towards the storm season. March 1st, meteorological spring is here, and we can kind of put the kibosh on winter weather, and it looks like we don't see any winter weather over the next week or so, but man, look at those rainfall totals over the last week to two. 2.63 officially for February, and we had 0.2 inch there in January, so we're just under 3 inches, slightly below normal officially here at Will Rogers Airport in Oklahoma City. Another blast of some heavy rain, southeast portions of the state, North Texas. It's just not Oklahoma, but North Texas have seen plenty of flooding rains in Arkansas. This storm system will be a big headline from New York to Boston. A lot of wind and heavy snow. Our next weather system's crashing in the Pacific Northwest. That'll bring us some more rain chances as we head towards Sunday and a slight chance of severe weather. High temperatures today, beautiful. March came in like a lamb, not like a lion. So the saying is, if it comes in like a lamb, it'll go out like a lion. So we'll have to wait and see if that happens at the end of March. But it was calm here today. A live look from our Air Comfort SkyCam network in Regency. 61 degrees, beautiful blue skies. Those north winds are starting to calm down, and they will settle down to less than 10 miles an hour as these temperatures right now, 50s and 60s, will cool down pretty quickly. So make sure if you're going to be out this evening, grab that jacket as we'll be in the low 40s to upper 30s in some of the low-lying areas by 11 o'clock. As you can see, those winds go light with those clear skies. Tomorrow afternoon, clear skies, lots of sunshine, temperatures back up into the 60s. South winds increasing that moisture as we head towards Saturday. So a mixture of sun and clouds throughout the day on Saturday, 60s, maybe a 70 or so. And then indications are we could see more clouds on Sunday. More clouds mean 50s and 60s and a slight chance of some drizzle, maybe some showers during the morning hours. And then as the cold front comes in, if we get some clearing, warm temperatures up, we could see some isolated strong to severe thunderstorms along that cold front by Sunday evening. All indications are isolated in nature. The risk of severe weather and storm coverage looks to be on the low side as some cooler air arrives early next week. And looking at rainfall totals, again, eastern half the state, best chance of rain, maybe a half to three quarters to an inch of rain, isolated, maybe a tenth of an inch here across central and west as it looks right now in the form of drizzle, maybe a couple light showers. Temperatures here tonight, lower 30s, maybe an upper 20 off toward the northwest. Sun-filled Friday, get out there and enjoy. Temperatures middle to upper 60s. Saturday, as we head into the weekend, a mixture of sun and clouds with south winds start to pick up. Temperatures 60s. If you see a little sunshine, lower 70s. And then Sunday, that front comes in, morning drizzle, maybe a couple showers, maybe a rumble of thunder. Sunday evening, as the front comes in, cools us down into the upper 50s. Monday into Tuesday, low 50s, as we're looking at, again, 60s back in the forecast and sunshine late next week in the Severe Weather Expo at the Penn Square Mall. Talking about severe weather, you can meet the entire team and all the trackers noon to 4, not this Saturday, but next Saturday. And by the way, daylight saving time starts that Sunday, the 11th.
Ooh. Okay.
Yeah.
March 11th.
Get that in your mind.
Yes.
The clocks are going to change then.
A little bit longer daylight hours.
Oh, love it.
Nice.
It is nice. Absolutely.
Justin, thanks.
Back with more after this.